The following is a conversation with His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on the 8th of October, 1975, in Durban, South Africa.
Krishna, the word Krishna means all attract. So unless one is all attractive, he cannot be God. So this Krishna consciousness means God consciousness. Our position, we all living entities, we are all a small particle, equal in quality with God, small, just like gold, a small particle of gold.
The spark.
Spark, yes, fire, big fire, and spark fire, both of them fire, but one is big and one is very small. So our relationship with God is eternal. At the present moment, on account of contact with this material energy, we have forgotten our relationship with God. Therefore, our life is problematic. We are facing so many problems. Again, if we revive our original consciousness, then we shall become happy. So this is the sum and substance of Krishna consciousness. Now, the process how to revive our original consciousness, there are different processes. But at the present moment, people are very, very fallen. And this is called the age of Kali, means most fallen.
Most fallen.
Most fallen. The so-called material advancement is not the solution. Because God is eternal, we are eternal. And in the material condition, we are changing our body. On account of our ignorance, we are thinking, I am this body. But I am not this body. I am that spark, spirit, part and parcel of God.
The body is just a vehicle.
Yes, covering. Vehicle also. It is just like a machine. You go from one place to another on a motor car machine. So this body is just like machine. On account of our material condition of life, we are thinking that if I get this position, then I'll be happy. If I get this position, I'll be happy. We are creating a mental concoction. But nothing will make us happy unless we come to our real position, that I am part and parcel of God. My business is to associate with God and help or cooperate with God. So that position we have to revive.
Yeah.
And there are different types of vehicle, aquatic animals, then plants. When the water is dried up, then vegetation comes. Then trees and plants, they cannot move. Then we get little improvement, we can move, just like flies, insects, microbes, reptiles and so many. There are 9 lakh forms of body within the water, then 2 million types of bodies in vegetable, and then 1,100,000 species of life, like microbes, germs, worms, insects. Then we come to the birds' life, 3 million different forms of. Then we come to beast life, that is, birds' life, 1 million. And then the beast life, 3 million. Then we come to human form of body, and especially gradually we become civilized. So when we are civilized, then it is a chance to understand what is God, what I am, what is our relationship. So if we don't take advantage of the civilized human life to understand God, and if we simply waste our life like cats and dogs jumping and going here, then this is a great missing point. So the Krishna Consciousness movement is to educate people not to miss this opportunity, to take full advantage on this human form of life and try to understand God and your relationship with God.
May I ask a few questions?
Yes.
Do we get a second chance if we don't make the most of this life? In other words, is reincarnation part of your...
Yes, second chance means you have to change your body. Now, according to your desire, you get another body. That body is not guaranteed that you shall get a human body.
If you've been bad enough, you might finish.
No, I have already told you, there are 8,400,000 different forms of life.
Yeah.
So you can enter any one of them according to your mental condition. We are under the control of the material nature. The material nature is being conducted in 3 modes: goodness, passion, and ignorance. So there's like 3 colors: yellow, red, and blue. Now you mix 3 into 3 = 9, 9 into 9 = 81. So these modes of material nature is being mixed up, therefore there are so many varieties of life. So if we transcend this coloring platform of material nature, we come to the pure consciousness, then we stop this repetition of birth and death in different forms of life. And if we do not learn, then there is chance of going down or going up. There are different planets. If you cultivate the modes of goodness, then you are promoted to the higher planetary system, higher standard of life. And if you don't improve, don't go down, then you may remain in the present stage. But out of ignorance, if you still degrade, commit sinful activities, violate the laws of nature, then we go down again. The animal life, the plant's life, like that. But again we have to evolve. Evolution is a process by nature. So it may take many millions of years. Therefore, a human being must be responsible that I have got this opportunity to get out of this cycle of birth and death and different forms of life, and let me properly understand God and what is my relationship with God and act accordingly, so that if we understand what is God, then we go back to home, back to garden.
What can an ordinary man do? I mean, the Krishna Consciousness movement involves shaving the head and wearing the saffron robe. What can the man who is caught up in family life do?
This saffron robe is not very essential or cut the hair, but it creates some good situation, mental, you see. It's like a military man, when he's dressed properly, he gets some energy to feel like a military man. But it does not mean that unless you are dressed, you cannot fight. It does not mean. So, consciousness can be revived in any condition, without any check. But these conditions are helpful. Therefore, it is prescribed that you live like this, you dress like this, you eat like this, you do like this. These are convenient. They are not essential. At the same time, if we take to these processes, then it will be helpful.
One can be a student of Krishna consciousness,
yes,
while going about a normal daily life.
Yes.
Do you think transcendental meditation is beginning to help?
They do not know what is meditation. They simply, it is a farce. That is another cheating process by the so-called Swamis and yogis. They do not know what is meditation. Do you know what is meditation? You are asking me the question, but do you know what is meditation?
Just a stilling of the mind, trying to sit in the center without swinging either way.
So what is the center?
Oh, I don't know.
Then why you are asking me? You do not know. So everyone does not know what is meditation, and they talk very much meditation. This is going on. These bluffers, they say meditation, but what is the subject matter of meditation, they do not know. Simply bogus propaganda. There are so many birds, eagle birds, they fly and they go from one planet to another. They're resting just like a bird, you see, they fly from one tree to another. So their resting place is one planet to another. You see, you are trying to go to the moon planet bogusly. I'd say bogusly, because you could not go there. The moon planet is far away from the sun planet. So it is not possible to go there by the so-called jets planet, no. It is far, far away. It is 1,600,000 miles away from the sun. The modern scientist's calculation is 93 million miles. The sun is situated, and above that, 1,600,000 miles up there is moon planet. So, by the Vedic calculation, it is not possible to go there. By the method we are attempting, that is not possible. And the proof is that why, if they are going to the moon planet, why they cannot stay there? Now, the argument is that there is no vegetation, the atmosphere is different, where living being cannot stay. They say like that. But from the Vedic information, we understand that moon planet influences vegetation in all other planets. So, if the moon planet helps vegetation in all other planets, how it is there is no vegetation? So there are many things, contradiction, and practically we see they are going to the moon planet but they cannot stay. Uselessly going and coming. So let them do that. But we have got our other sources of information, that we cannot go to the moon planet. We have no new discovery. We don't manufacture. This is our process. We simply follow the predecessor's instruction. Our movement is very easy, because we haven't got to manufacture something. We simply repeat the words and the instruction given by the predecessor. Krishna instructed Brahma, Brahma instructed Narada, Narada instructed Vyasadeva instructed Madhyacharya. And in this way, then Madhavendra Puri, Ishwar Puri, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, then the six Goswamis, then the Srinivasa Acharya, Kaviraj Goswami, Nartam Das Thakur, Vishwanath Chakravarti, Jagannath Das Babaji, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Gaur Kishore Das Babaji, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati, and then we are doing the same thing. There is no difference. That is the specific procedure of the Krishna Consciousness movement. You are singing daily Guru Bukha Padva Vakka Chittete Koriya Oikko Arna Koriya Mane As. Very simple thing. We are receiving the transcendental knowledge through Guru Parampara, succession. So we have to simply take instruction from Guru, and if we execute that to our heart and soul, that is success. That is practical. I have no personal qualification, but I simply try to satisfy my Guru. That's all. My Guru Maharaj asked me that if you get some money, you print books. So there was a private meeting talking, some of my important in God brothers also there, it was in Radha Kunda. So Guru Maharaj was speaking to me that since we have got this Bhagavajar marble temple, there has been so many dissensions. And everyone is thinking we'll occupy this room or that room, that room. I wish, therefore, to sell this temple and the marble and print some book.
Yes. So I took up this from his mouth, that he's very fond of books. And he told me personally that if you get some money, print books. Therefore I'm stressing on this point. Where is book, where is book, where is book? So kindly help me. This is my request. Print as many books in as many languages and distribute throughout the whole world. Then Krishna consciousness movement will automatically increase. Now the educated, learned scholars, they are appreciating our movement by reading books, by taking practical results. Dr. Stills and Judah, he has written one book, perhaps you know, Hare Krishna and Counter Culture. A very nice book about our movement, and he is giving importance. He has admitted that, Swamiji, you have done a wonderful thing, service to the humanity. They are plunged into ignorance. All these are rascals, mura. It is not our manufactured word. Krishna says, carries different flavor of the physical elements, like the flavor of some flower or the aromatic dust in the flower, and on account of different dust, the ear sends in different flavor or accepts different color. Similarly, everyone has got a certain type of desire, so according to his desire, the Lord appears to him. Although such appearance, such form, is not his original form. So the demigods are actually not the original form of the Lord, but they are presented to different persons according to their desires. So Dakha, he wants to worship the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna. He is not interested with the demigods. Purport. The impersonalists, they imagine the form of the Lord as different demigods. Just like the Mayavadis, they worship Panchopasana, five demigods. Actually, they do not believe in the form of the Lord, but for the facility of the worshipper, they think one may imagine some form. Generally, they imagine the form of Vishnu, the form of Shiva, the form of Ganesh, the form of Durga, and the form of Sun God.
Shiva, form of Ganesh, the form of
the Sun God. This is called Panchopasana. But Dukkha wanted to worship not that imaginary form, but the Supreme Form of the Lord, Krishna. Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur gives in this connection a description of difference of the Supreme Personality of Godhead and ordinary living being. So this is
difference of the Supreme Personality of God, an ordinary living being.
This has been described in the previous verse, Sarvam Pumana Vida Gunang Sutatya Navida Sarvagga Mananta Mire. The purport is that Supreme Lord, He is omnipotent, omniscient, He knows everything, but the living being does not know actually what is the position of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. That is the difference between the Supreme Personality of Godhead and ordinary living being. In the Bhagavad Gita, it is also said, Krishna says, I know everything, but nobody knows me. This is the difference. In the Kunti's prayer in Srimad Bhagavatam, Queen Kunti says, my dear Lord, you are existing outside and inside, still nobody can see you. So, conditioned soul cannot understand what is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, neither by speculative knowledge nor by imagination. One has to know the Supreme Personality of Godhead by the grace of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. He reveals. He cannot be understood by speculation. Athapi te deva padambujadvayam prasada leshanu grihita evahi janati tattam nachanna yukopi chiranga vichinna. This is the verdict of the Shastra, that an ordinary man may be a great philosopher. He can speculate on the absolute truth, what he is, what is his form, how he is existing, but he cannot understand. But a person who has gone through the devotional service, Sevan Mukhe Hi Jivhadu, Sayaveva Svaratvadu, one can understand the Supreme Personality of Godhead only through devotional service. And in the Bhagavad Gita, it is also explained by the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Bhaktyamam avijanati javan jaschami tat-tat. So, less intelligent person, they want to imagine or concoct the form of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. But those who are devotees, they want to see the actual Personality of Godhead. Therefore, the Dukkha, he prays, the other may think of yourself as impersonal or personal and some imaginary, but I wish to pray to your Lord, say, you fulfill my desire so that I can see you actually as you are. So, that's all.
Mahaprabhu Kirtan Savita Balitramadhyam Manasurasena Romanchakam Pasu Taranga Bhaja Bandhu Gura Vande Jagat Sri Charanarvindam.
Also not secure. Is that very nice life? That is our motto. Krishna is sun. Krishna Surya Sama. So when Krishna sun is there, all these glowworms, lightning, will be finished. Keep this sun always shining. Then these glowworms will be finished. One that sick bhajan,
yogi bhajan.
He came to invite me.
Really? Yes. In Hawaii?
Yes.
He came to our temple a few nights ago. Also, the RT.
He has a big following.
So he came to invite me. I indirectly refused.
Yeah. He has a very big following.
Bhujaya gunarupa namna
Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari.
Ananta Kodi Vaishnavinda Ki
Jai. So you may have $2 million, I may have $10, you may have $100. Everyone has got some riches. That is admitted. But nobody can say that I have got all the riches. That is not possible. If somebody can say that I have got all the riches, he is God. That is spoken by Krishna. Nobody has said in the history of the world. Krishna said, Bhoktaram jagatamatham sarvaloka mahisram. I am the enjoyer of everything. And I am the proprietor of all the universe. Who can say that? That is God. Aishajyasya, samagrasya. Samagra means total, not that partial. That I have got so much, now I have distributed. I do not wish to mention by name one artificial god. He was teaching his disciple, and the disciple was feeling electrical shocks. So unfortunately, I cannot give you electrical shocks. You see? Electrical shocks, and he became fainted by electrical shocks. And these are written publicly, and fools are accepting. Why teachers should give electrical shocks? Where is that mentioned in the Shastra? But these things are bogus things are stated. Electrical shock. And when he fainted, then the god was sitting, and when he got his senses, then the disciple asked God, Sir, why you are crying? Now I have finished everything. I have given you everything. Does a teacher finishes everything by teaching his disciple? These things are going on. So, Krishna is not that kind of God, that I have finished everything. Purnasya purnamadaya purnameva ushishyati. This is definition of God. God is so perfect and full that even if you take all his opulences, he still is full. That is God. Not that I have finished my talk. So intelligent man should learn what is God from the Vedic information. Don't manufacture God. Manufacture, how we can manufacture God? That is not possible. So that is called monodharma. By mental concoction, mental speculation, we cannot create God. Here is the definition of God. That ishavasamidam sarvam
vande gurati charanaravindam vande gurati charanaravindam shri krishna chaitanya prabhu nityananda Bravo.
Almera and bring my handbag. This almanac, closet. I love to also keep a record, so you can, for transfer, receive the check.
Yes.
Is that all right?
Yes.
I'm giving in favor of DBT.
Yes.
And you...
We are acting like your bank.
Huh?
We are at BBT is acting like your bank.
Yes, that's it. That is it.
Prabhupada, I have one question about Guru Kripa Swami's Lakshmi that he collects. Each month he is paying to Dai Nippon.
There's a proposal for Bhaktivedanta magazine article. Satsuru Maharaj wanted you to see it beforehand. That it's a to show how I am not this body. This is a man who's thinking thoughtfully, and he's saying, I'm not this head, I'm not this chest, I'm not this arm like that, just to illustrate it graphically.
Satsuru Maharaj.
He had some question if you would like it or
What is that?
And this is a person who's thinking. I can remember I was a baby sitting on the lap of my mother, and now I'm in the middle of my life, and I know I will become old and die, but who am I? I'm not this body which is changing so much. I'm trying to put these concepts into visual terms so people can easily understand them. That type is not what it will be printed. That's just to show how the layout will look. the type will be different. It's just the visual that we're...
I love to read it.
No, he was, the reading part he was confident about. He simply was wondering about this illustration. He said it was clinical. And he did not know if he would like it or not. Because it shows the different body parts and the person is thinking, I'm not this head, I'm not this chest, and I'm not this leg. That's what he was mostly concerned with, more than the written. If you like, I can leave the written matter. I have it written.
Hmm. Yes.
But as far as the illustration, that we plan to have a painting, one of the paintings by the artists.
what he has seen, therefore there is no use of seeing. What is this argument? This is no argument.
They also say that no one can ever be pure, that everyone is doomed to be
a
sinner.
Well, that is atmavat mannate jagat. That is the conditioned soul's qualification, that he is a fool, he thinks other fools. Everyone, he thinks he is like me. That is nature. Atmavat mannate jagat. Everyone thinks others like himself. If he's a fool, he thinks all that. So these things are no argument. Nobody has seen God. How do you take the statistics? Can you say like that, any statistics that nobody has? Maybe they have not seen him or has seen God. That is quite possible, because you have not scrutinizedly studied all the men of the world.
Yes.
Then how you can say nobody has seen? You have not seen the man who has seen him.
So the man...
He will not admit his fault. He will accuse others. Nobody has seen that. Why? You may not have seen, but why you say nobody has seen? You have not seen that person who has seen God. Therefore you say like that.
So those people who wrote the Bible did not see God.
That is, when God is canvassing, here I am, Krishna, they will not see it. And still they accuse nobody has seen. Giri Baradhadi Jaya Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari Kunjabihari Jaswoda Nandana Vrajana Ranjana Jaswoda Nandana Vrajana Ranjana Jamuna Tira Bana Chari Jamuna Tira Bana Chari Jaya Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari Gopi Jana Balabha Giri Baradhari
Gopi Jana Balabha
Gopi Jana Balabha Giri Baradhari Jaswoda Nandana Vrajana Ranjana Jaswoda Nandana Vrajana Ranjana Jamuna Tira Bana Chari Jamuna Tira Banachari Jaya Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari Jaya Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari
Radha Krishna Bhagavana Sam Kunda Radha Kunda Griyo Jan Ki Jai Vrindavan Dham Ki Jai Navadvip Dham Ki Jai Ganga Mai Ki Jai Jamuna Mai Ki Jai Dwarka Dham Ki Jai Swami to Bhaktivedanta Ki Jai All glories to the Ashram All glories to the Ashram Thank you very much
All glories to you Srila Prabhupada
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. So Krishna has given you a very nice engagement, husband and wife. Very Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Ram. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Ram. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Ram. We'll be right back.
Gange, don't do three pada. Just try. Take dadagina, take tatagina. Take dadagina, take tatagina.
Can I try
with you? Yes, it is coming.
I think it's just too fast.
Huh?
No. If
you can try. Give him, you can try.
Prabhupada? On our tape recorder here that we have, we can make it so you can play nicely and then later on at our own time we will take to play at the mandanga and kartals nicely. This way we won't waste any of your time.
So
do you think that's a good idea?
They can read dub over the tape.
See, we can, after you are gone, at our own time we can play nicely. Do you think that is a good idea or not?
I do not know.
We think it will.
I'm not an expert.
Well, if we can't get someone to play drum,
we would like to do that.
You want to try?
We would like to do it like that, Prabhupada.
Then do that.
No, if we get the people to play now, that'd be the.
Father wanted me to become like this. Know everything, what is going on. He never wanted me to be a worldly man, earning money. He never wanted. There was some arrangement for my going to England after my college education to become barrister. My father refused. No, my son is not going to be a lecturer.
Ready? I'm ready. All you need is put on
Yes, Taking lesson from professors who has mind clear. Why the students are coming to you? Because his mind is not clear. He has to clear his mind by teaching him psychology, feeling, thinking, feeling, willing. That's what he has to come to, a learned man who knows how to understand mind, how to understand the activities of the mind, how to deal with them. That requires education. A dog cannot take this education, but a human being can take. So one professor, Dr. W.S. Arkwart, he was our professor for psychology, metaphysics. Later on he became the Vice Chancellor of Calcutta University. A very nice gentleman.
Dr. Myers finds that he's chanting Hare Krishna a little in the shower now. When he takes a shower, he chants a little now.
One press reporter in the Berkeley University in the beginning, he wrote his article and he wrote that after hearing this Hare Krishna for a few minutes, I came home chanting all the road Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. So giving some prasad.
Yeah, it's amazing.
Hare Hare. your pride, your property, your family, your bank balance, your skyscraper building, all taken. Finish. Go out. This is God. Now you understand God? To believe or not believe, God will come one day. He'll take you, take your everything, and get out. That is God. You believe or not believe, it doesn't matter. The same example, the tenant may not believe the landlord, but when the landlord will come with court's order, get out, then you have to go. That is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. But those who are not believers in God, to them I come as death and take away everything. Finish. That one has to believe. Yes, as sure as death, then God is here. You may challenge, so long you have got little life for a few years. But God will come and drive you away from your present pride, prestigious position. Get out. So unless one is madman, he cannot say there is no God. Anyone who denies the existence of God, he is a madman.
Prabhupada, wouldn't it be better to say he's blind, he's stupid?
Yes, the same thing. The mad is the sum total of all stupidity. When I say mad, it is the sum total of all kinds of stupidity. Now we can give them prasadam. I think we have occupied their time.